spiritual development plays an important part in the making of a United States Marine. Lieutenant Junior Grade Alicio Morales, Chaplain Corps, United States Navy, will deliver the graduation prayer. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise.
Let us pray. Mighty One, we thank you for your presence here today. We give you thanks for these young men who came in as recruits and are leaving as Marines. Through their hard work and perseverance, they now join the family ranks of the finest fighting force on earth. Within each and every one of them runs the war-fighting spirit of a Marine that never gives up, no matter the odds. We give you thanks for the family and friends who provide support through thoughts, prayers, and letters of encouragement. They celebrate in this great reunion. We give you thanks for the drill instructors, for they have made Marines. Through the discipline, leadership, and sacrifice, they have instilled the honor, courage, and commitment that is woven into the very fabric of this Corps. It is because of them that these new Marines can now live out the great honor traditions to always be faithful, first to fight, and most ready when the nation is least ready. We give you thanks for your continued blessings, and we ask that you continue to watch over this Corps and country. Amen.
Thank you. Please be seated. The Commanding General of Marine Corps Crew Depot San Diego welcomes you to what is a historic event in the life of a Marine, their graduation from boot camp. Approximately 40 weeks each year for the past 100 years, new Marines have departed San Diego for service with units of the Marine Corps around the globe. The primary mission of the Recruit Depot is to provide basic training to recruits enlisted west of the Mississippi, which represents approximately 51% of all applicants in the Marine Corps each year. The depot is also home to Recruiter School and Drill Instructor School. All of our efforts here are geared toward one end, producing America's finest fighting force, the United States Marines. This morning, Company K, 3rd Recruit Training Battalion, Recruit Training Regiment, will form and march in the parade. Following the passing review, the graduating Marines will return front and center of the reviewing stand for final dismissal. The staff for today's parade is comprised of Marines from the Recruit Training Regiment. The commander of troops is Captain William J. Kreitzer, Company Commander, Company K, 3rd Recruit Training Battalion. The parade adjutant is Captain Stuart J. Bullitt, Executive Officer, Company K, 3rd Recruit Training Battalion, Recruit Training Regiment. The marching units are now being called to attention, and the adjutant's command, sound adjutant's call, will begin today's parade. Marines from Company K. Among the 417 Marines, these traits offer. Discipline. The achievement of a state of discipline, which assures respect for authority, instinct, and willing obedience to orders, and the self-reliance to maintain or improve those traits which exemplify your aim. Military bearing. Consistently demonstrating military presence and personal awareness, as well as the proper wearing and maintenance of uniforms. Esprit de corps. Acquiring the common spirit of the Marine Corps. Inspires enthusiasm, devotion, pride, initiative, teamwork, aggressiveness, determination, moral courage, integrity, camaraderie, and the burning desire to work with and for others toward excellence in common goals. For 245 years, the Marines have fought and won whenever and wherever the nation falls, in the harshest conditions, over the most brutal terrain, and against the most formidable enemies, Marines defend the ideals of freedom with grit and tenacity. Though battlefields change, and capabilities evolve, history proves that true victory comes from the individual Marine with steeled resolve, the drive to overcome any obstacle, and the warrior spirit to fight on against all odds. It takes that steadfast faithfulness, separate by doubts, to Corps, country, and each other that abounds throughout our storied legacy. Marines today remain in combat or deployed throughout the world, confronting every challenge with courage, loyalty, and faithfulness. They are resolved to be most ready when the nation is least ready, to defend freedom anytime and anywhere, to stand ready to aid those devastated by natural disasters, to pay tribute to those who have forged our proud legacy, and to honor the families and loved ones who faithfully stand beside us. Will the Marines of Company K, today marks the end of the 13-week recruit training cycle. They have marched countless miles at Camp Pendleton and on this parade day, and have been trained, as are all Marines, as basic riflemen. In addition, due to an intensive physical training program, their strength and endurance have doubled since their arrival aboard the Recruit Depot. They are Marines, qualified to take their places in the ranks of the world's finest fighting organization. Now being aligned from left to right in order to get them into their exact positions for the parade. The next portion of the ceremony will be our national anthem, We welcome veterans and members of the armed forces to join us in rendering appropriate honors with a military salute. For guests who have not served in the military, it is proper etiquette during the national anthem to place the right hand over their hearts, and for those in the audience wearing headgear, to remove it. Will the guests please rise for the presentation of the colors? Ladies and gentlemen, our national anthem. Thank you. the commander of troops. title, United States Marine. Men who have helped shape our history join us here today. In keeping with the tradition of once a Marine, always a Marine, we would like to recognize them. At this time, those in the audience who have served as Marines, please rise. Ladies and gentlemen, a round of applause for your medical service.
Commitment
so that we create Marines of exemplary character, both at peace and war. They have been trained in battlefield-tested warfighting skills so that when this nation calls, its Marines always win. And thanks to the marksmanship instructors at Weapons Field Training Battalion up in Camp Pendleton, when these Marines arrive on their objective, they are capable of delivering precision rifle fire at pinpoint targets at staggering distances out to 500 yards. Today, Weapons Field Training Battalion is represented by Sergeant Scott, who is the marksmanship instructor for our company high shooter, Private First Class School. Outstanding job, Sergeant Scott. And finally, we created small unit leaders out of each of them and evaluated their ability to decide, act, and communicate with a bias for intelligent action, for that is what the future operating environment will demand. Now, in addition to all of this, I hope you noticed a few other upgrades we've installed. They probably stood a little taller. They certainly looked a little leaner. They would look you in the eyes and said these strange phrases like, yes, sir, yes, ma'am. Moms and dads, it should be a long time before you have to tell one of these Marines to get a job or a haircut. And I assure you, they know how to clean up after themselves and make their beds. But it is the change within that we are the most proud of. For having been indoctrinated in our core values, and then by virtue of the fact that they stand here today, means they've embraced those values as their own. And it is because of this journey they have made, because of the physical, mental, and moral development they displayed, which was built upon the foundation that you all laid, that I am proud to present 417 young men who through their own blood, sweat, and tears can now and forever claim the title of United States Marine. Now, if you'll excuse me for one moment while I address our new Marines one last time. Good morning, Marines.
Good morning, sir.
Did you all hear that? That is pure pride. That is pride in themselves and pride in the title that they have earned. Now, Kilo Company, I know when you arrived here so many weeks ago, the last thing on your mind was graduation. You were probably thinking, what in the world have I gotten myself into, and how do I get them to stop yelling at me? But you stand here today as America's newest Marines, having accomplished something that most would never dare attempt. And when you get home this weekend, people are going to look up to you. They're going to be proud of you, as they should. And your friends are going to ask you how you did it. And when your friends ask you that, what I want you to do is take them for a walk down to the recruiting station and introduce them to your recruiter. Because I can promise you, your drill instructors would love to meet your friends. But just remember that with this new title comes a great responsibility. For the strength of the Marine Corps is not found in a weapon system or piece of equipment. It is found in the warfighting spirit of the individual Marine. That is what matters most in combat, and that is what makes us different. This world is a dangerous and chaotic place, but that is why we have you. And the legacy of our Corps, of not only being the first to fight, but to always win, belongs to you now for safekeeping. And that eagle globe and anchor that we handed you on top of the Reaper represents 245 years of all of the Marines that have gone before you. So be proud of yourself. Be proud of what you have accomplished. But remember who you now are and who you now represent, and always remember to protect what you earn. So on behalf of the officers, the drill instructors, and all of the support personnel here at Ware Marine Corps Recruit Depot San Diego, let me be the first to wish you fair winds, following seas, Semper Fidelis Marines, welcome to our Corps.
today's parade reviewing official, Colonel Thomas M. Bedell, commanding officer, Marine Corps Air Station, Miramar, California. He's accompanied by Colonel Joseph W. Jones, commanding officer, Recruit Training Regiment, Marine Corps Recruit Depot, San Diego, California. Thomas M. Bedell, commanding officer, Marine Corps Air Station, Miramar, California. Colonel Bedell is a native of Lexington, Virginia, and was commissioned in 1997. After graduating the basic school, Colonel Bedell attended aviation flight training and obtained the military occupational specialty of 7509, Marine Corps Pilot, Marine Attack Squadron. Colonel Bedell has served in a variety of challenging billets in numerous commands, to include serving as a logistics officer, powerline officer, and airframe officer at Marine Attack Squadron 214, pilot training officer, weapons and tactics instructor, and maintenance officer at Marine Attack Squadron 211, operations officer at Special Operations Command War Game Center, commanding officer at Marine Transport Squadron 1, Air Force liaison at Marine Forces Korea, and the director at Commandant of the Marine Corps Safety Division. Colonel Bedell currently serves as the commanding officer for Marine Corps Air Station, Miramar, California. His awards include the Legion of Merit, Defense Meritorious Service Medal, Meritorious Service Medal with 2 gold stars in lieu of 3rd award, the Air Medal with Strike Flight Numeral 14, Navy and Marine Corps Combination Medal, and the Navy and Marine Corps Achievement Medal with 1 gold star in lieu of 2nd award. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome Colonel Thomas M. Bedell.
Thank you.
San Diego for combat in conflicts around the world, including places whose names are immediately associated with Marine courage and dedication. Names such as Guadalcanal, Tarawan, Iwo Jima, Busan, Incheon, Chosin Reservoir, Kaesong, Wei City, Lebanon, Grenada, Panama, Kuwait, Somalia, Fallujah, Iraq, Pajab, Afghanistan, and our most current operations worldwide. This parade day is rich in history and tradition, and no Marine train here ever forgets its sights and sounds. Ladies and gentlemen, the Commander of Troops, Captain William J. Kratzer, Company Commander and the Regimental Staff.
Thank you.
first as Marine Band San Diego performs the Marine's Hymn. Will the guests please rise? Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we would like to introduce to you the Marines responsible for ensuring the success of the difficult transition required to become a Marine. The company commander is Captain William J. Chrysler. The company first sergeant is General Sergeant Carlos F. Hernandez. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in a round of applause for the company staff of Company K. The next portion of the ceremony will be the traditional function of retiring the guidons.